good for you. I'm empty hanging and I'm feeling blue and I'm gonna dream.
My interest for beer started a long time ago, actually. Late 90s, when I was studying to be a school teacher. And I started to drink beer also. And back then, Denmark was a country controlled by Carlsberg, pretty much. And you can only pretty much get Carlsberg in Denmark. And I just found it boring to drink the same thing all the time. So I made a little beer club for 15 friends, where we met every second month. And everybody had to bring a beer, and we tasted it and talked about it. So that was kind of how I got into it.
Mmm, it's good. Really intense.
I started to brew on my own, also in connection with the beer club. So we tasted all these different beers in the club, and one day just decided it would be fun to try and do our own stuff and see if we could do something that was as good as the beers that we bought. We get approached a lot from people that want to, you know, be involved in opening trust all over the world, Japan, London, even Denmark, but you know, we'll see. In the beginning, it was a plan to just open a beer bar, but we found this space that we're sitting in now, and it had a full kitchen that we got for free. And I just found it stupid to pull out a whole kitchen. So I was like, you know, if you get the whole kitchen, if you get a free kitchen, why don't we actually use it and open the restaurant also? I mean, the main difference between New York and Copenhagen is definitely that the speed or the pace in New York is way higher. Someone has told me one time that 60% of all restaurants close within the first 5 years in New York. We wanted to be like a local bar also. It was important for us to get the local community to have a place where they wanted to hang out. But right, you know, we ended up getting everything. We get the suits from Manhattan, we get the local people that live next door, we get people that travel all the way from Japan or from Denmark. We get a lot of Danish tourists also, a lot of Danish tourists. Best thing about having my own bar is that I always have free beer. No, I mean, it's cool. I mean, I like to run businesses, and I have a lot of businesses. And, you know, it's hard work, but I like, you know, for me it's also a good way where I can present my beers to the public.